Welcome. In this video, we will see how to generate a PWM waveform using PIC16F877. So this PWM waveform is generally used for controlling speed of a DC motor. So PIC16F877 is having an inbuilt PWM module which is used for generating this PWM waveform. So the PWM waveform that is available in 16F877 microcontroller is of 10 bits, means the resolution of that PWM waveform is of 10 bits. Right? The PWM waveform is made available on this CCP1 pin, which is multiplexed with the port C pin of microcontroller, and that's why we have to make that pin as output pin. Then a PWM waveform looks something like this. So here, this is the time period of the PWM waveform, and in this time period, the on time tells us the duty cycle. So the duty cycle is actually the on time divided by the total time period, and it can be between 0 to 100%. Frequency of PWM signal is decided by the value that is stored in this PR2 resistor, and the duty cycle of PWM waveform is decided by the value stored in the CCPR1L resistor, okay, which is nothing but the duty cycle resistor. So while generating this PWM waveform, the timer 2 module is required, okay. So whenever we start this PWM generation, at that time the value in timer 2 goes on incrementing, and this value is continuously compared with the value of this duty cycle resistor. And whenever the value in timer 2 and duty cycle resistor becomes equal, the output of the pin is made low. Okay, and again the counting in timer 2 continues, and it is again continuously compared with the value that is stored in PR2 resistor. Okay, and whenever the value in timer 2 becomes equal to this PR2 resistor, again the pin is made high, okay? And this is repeated continuously. So this is how the PWM waveform is generated. So the time period of the PWM signal is decided by the value that is stored in this PR2 resistor, okay? So the formula that is available in the datasheet of PIC16F877 microcontroller is this one. And this formula can be modified to find out the value of PR2 resistor. So it is like this: PR2 is equal to F oscillator. F oscillator is nothing but the crystal frequency that we have connected to our circuit, divided by PWM frequency. So this PWM frequency is the required frequency for our PWM signal, okay, into 4 into the timer 2 prescaler value, okay, minus 1. So this gives us the value of PR2 resistor, and this PR2 resistor is a 8-bit resistor. Then when timer 2 is equal to PR2, the following 3 events occur on the next increment cycle. So timer 2 value is first of all cleared, okay, before the start of the next cycle. Then this CCP1 pin is set, okay, to start the new cycle. And the PWM duty cycle is latched from the CCPR1L into CCPR1H register. Okay, so the duty cycle is stored in this CCPR1L register. So this is the format of CCP1 control register, which is used for configuring the PWM module. Okay, so again it is a 8-bit register. Out of that, the lower 4 bits are used for configuring the CCP module. Okay, now we want to configure it as PWM module, so we have to use this last option, that is 11XX. So it means that these 2 pins should be 11, and don't care about the value of these 2 bits. Okay, so we have to set these 2 bits equal to 1, and these 2 bits, that is CCP XX and CCP XY, these 2 are the lower 2 bits of the resolution of PWM. Okay, so these 2 bits along with the bits that are present in CCPR1L determine the resolution of the PWM waveform. then the PWM duty cycle can be calculated with the help of this formula that is available in the datasheet of PEEK-16F877 microcontroller. So if we modify this formula, we will get this, and from that formula actually we have to find out the value that we have to store in the CCPR1L register, okay, along with the two bits in CCP1 control register. So here now in our case we are going to use a potentiometer to change the duty cycle of the PWM waveform, and that's why the value or the output value of ADC will be used to decide the duty cycle. Okay, so here the inbilt ADC in PEEK-16F877 is used, okay, which is again of 10 bit resolution. So the maximum output of ADC will be of 10 bits, or it will be 1023. Okay, so we have divided it by again 1023 value to normalize that value between 0 to 1. Okay, and then this factor decides the duty cycle. Okay, so we have to multiply this value with the total time period of the PWM signal. Okay, so that will give us the duty cycle. Okay, but again it is multiplied by 4. Now because we want to generate a 10 bit value that should be stored in this CCPR1L and CCP1 CON 5 and 4 bits, and this PR2 is actually a 8 bit register, right? So to convert that into a 10 bit value, we are going to multiply it by 4. Okay, so that is how we have generated the duty cycle value, and that is stored in this CCPR1L and CCP1 CON 5 and 4 bits. So this is the setup that is required for PWM operation. So first thing is set the PWM time period by writing to PR2 register. So we have used a formula to find out the value of PR2 register. Then after that, set the PWM cycle by writing to CCPR1L register and these two bits from CCP1 CON register. So this decides the resolution of PWM. This decides the time period of the PWM signal. Then after that, make the CCP1 pin an output by clearing the TRISC2 bit, because this is multiplexed with the port C pin. Right? Then after that, set the timer to prescale value and enable the timer 2 by writing to T2 CON register. So now we have to choose appropriate timer 2 prescale value, and then again start the timer or enable the timer by writing to T2 CON control register. And finally, configure the CCP1 module for PWM operation using the CCP1 control register. So these are the steps that we have to follow while configuring the PWM module. Now we'll see the demonstration and the code for generating the PWM waveform. Okay, so now this is the code that I've written for generating the PWM waveform. So here first I have used the high-tech C compiler for writing this C code in MPLAB software. So for that we need this header file, that is htc.h, okay, which is related to HTC or high-tech compiler. Then we have defined here the crystal frequency using this variable underscore xtal underscore frequency equal to 20 megahertz, right? After that we have decided the prescale value for timer 2 as 4, okay, and we have created a variable with this name tmr2 prescale. Then using this underscore underscore config f oscillator underscore hs, we have configured the crystal oscillator for PEEK-16F877 microcontroller as high speed crystal oscillator, and we have turned off the watchdog timer, okay, using this statement. Then after that we have defined one variable long PWM underscore frequency equal to 5000. So this is nothing but the frequency required for our PWM signal. It is nothing but 5 kilohertz, right? Then here we have the main program. Okay, so in that we have one variable int ADC underscore value, which is used for storing the ADC output value. Then using this TRISC we have created the port 2 as output port, okay, because the CCP one pin is present on port C. You can make the individual pin as output as well instead of the entire port. Then here using TRIS A 0xFF, we have made the port A as input port because the ADC pin is multiplexed with port A pin. Okay, again you can make the single pin as input instead of the entire port. Then next, this is ADC initialized function. So using this function, we can initialize the ADC. Okay, so this is that function. So here ADCON 0 and ADCON 1 are configured with some values. Using this ADCON 0, we have turned on the ADC module and we have decided the clock frequency for ADC as F oscillator by 16. And using this ADCON 1, we have set the internal reference voltage as the reference voltage for the ADC conversion. And at the same time, we have kept the result as write justified. For details on how to use this ADC module, you can look at my another video on ADC module. Then after that, the next function we have called is PWM initialize. So using this, the PWM module is configured. So here this is the PWM initialize function, which can be used for initializing or configuring the PWM module. So here what we have done is we have implemented the same formula that we have seen previously, that is for finding out the time period of PWM signal, and that value is stored in this PR2 resistor. Then CCP1 M3 equal to 1 and CCP1 M2 equal to 1. So these two bits are present in CCP1 control resistor, which should be made equal to 1 in order to configure the CCP module as PWM module. Then using these two bits T2CKPS0 and T2CKPS1, we have configured the prescaler of timer with a value of 4. Then we have turned on the timer using this TMR2 on equal to 1, and we have made here TRISC equal to 0. It means that the CCP1 pin will be made as output pin. Then after that, we have here a do while loop. So inside this do loop, we have first of all used the ADC module to convert the analog value available on channel 0 to an equivalent digital value, and that digital value will be stored in this ADC underscore value variable. Then this is that function ADC read. So using this, we can convert analog value into a digital value. Okay, so again here all the details that I have described over here I have already covered in my previous video, so I will not go through details. So here the 10 bit result is generated, and out of that 8 bits are present in this ADRESL resistor and 2 bits are present in ADRESH register, right? Now a single 10 bit value is created by using this statement ADRES left shifted by 8 bits, because already 8 bits are present in ADRESL, and those plus ADRESL means those are concatenated together and a 10 bit value is created. Then after that, here in ADC value, we are going to get the 10 bit digital value. So that value is given as input to this function PWM underscore duty. So using this, the duty cycle will be generated. So this is that function PWM underscore duty, and here the value ADC value will be given as input to this function. Okay, so that value is now here converted into float for calculation purpose. Okay, because we are going to have some fractional values in this case. And we have normalized it by 1023. This we have discussed previously now. So in this variable duty, we'll get the value. Okay, so digital value that must be stored in CCPR1L register. Okay, so this duty will be a 10 bit value. Okay, so out of those 10 bits, the lower 2 bits are stored in this CCP1X and CCP1Y bits, which are present in again CCP1 control resistor, and the remaining 8 bits, higher 8 bits, are stored in this CCPR1L resistor. Using this statement, duty right shifted by 2 bits means the lower 2 bits will be discarded because those are already stored in these 2 bits, and the remaining upper 8 bits will be stored in this CCPR1L resistor. Then after that, some delay is generated, a delay of 50 milliseconds is generated before the next cycle. okay, and this is kept in while one loop. So this will generate the PWM waveform as per the analog value generated using the pot. Okay, and this PWM signal we can use for controlling the speed of the DC motor. Okay, so I will compile this code and now we'll see the output in this Proteus software. Okay, so here I have already built the circuit. This is the PIC16F877 microcontroller. This is a pot. Okay, and this is a L293D driver IC which is used for driving the DC motor. Okay, and we are going to also check the waveform on the CCP1 pin. Okay, so you can double click on this, you can go to this program file and you can select the hex file. Here the name of my project is pwm.hex, so I'll select that, click on open. Okay, and I will run it. Okay, so as soon as I start it, here you can see there is no waveform because the pot it has 0%. Okay, means no waveform is there, so the motor is not rotating. So if I go on increasing this, you will see here the pulses begin to appear, and as I go on increasing the pot value, the on time of the waveform goes on increasing. Okay, and the duty cycle of the waveform also goes on increasing. Okay, and at the same time you can see here the speed of the motor is also increasing. Okay, so don't look at the rotations of the motor because those are uneven because of the excessive load on the CPU. You can check this value. Okay, so this value is increasing, it means that the speed of motor is also increasing. So if I again decrease that, the value here will go on decreasing. Okay, so this is how you can generate the PWM waveform using PIC16F877, and that PWM waveform can be used for controlling the speed of the DC motor. If you have liked this video, please do like, share and subscribe to my channel StudyTronics. Thank you.